Hey guys, what is up? Austin here, aka Bowtie Guy 97. And today we got more snow here in Virginia. It was a whole lot more about 4 hours ago, but the temperature is going up. It's still snowing, but it's like, you know, 37, 38. So the snow on the ground's melted. So it's really only down to about 2 or 3 inches. There was about 4 or 5 here. But last night, which is kind of hard to film at night, I got to try out the new tires in the snow. And that is what this video is going to be about today. But before we get started, if you're not already, hit that subscribe button. We got a lot of cool stuff coming up. If you're a subscriber, you know I talked about getting the light bar after I did the exhaust. The new light bar should be here today. I was kind of hoping it was going to be here before I did this video, just to show it here on the video, but it is not, thanks to UPS. So, gotta wait for that. I'll be installing that this weekend. Now, if you're not, also follow me on Instagram at Austin04_Z71. That'll be down in the description below. Then you're going to see the light bar before it goes up on YouTube. Just like last night, if you were on my Instagram, you saw me taking the truck around in the snow. It was some cool pictures on my story of the truck in the middle of the road in the snow and everything with the underglow on and all that. It was probably one of my favorite pictures I've ever taken of the truck. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Now, if you've been a subscriber on here for the past couple months, you know I did a video back when I had mud tires on these wheels. Actually, it was a different wheel and tire altogether. But I said, are mud tires any good in the snow? And here's a little clip from that video, just in case you missed it. Now, my ultimate conclusion was they were not the greatest tire I ever had in the snow. They did just fine. The truck is four-wheel drive. It's not like I had any issues at all. But it left a lot to be desired compared to the all-terrain tires that I've had in the past in the snow. Now, if you saw the last video, we installed a set of Toyo Open Country RTs. Now, the rugged terrain is a mix between the mud terrain and the all-terrain. And it's supposed to be the hybrid tire that offers the ultimate on-road, off-road type, you know, tire and experience. They're supposed to be rugged enough to handle muddy terrain, rough terrain and all that, hence rugged terrain. But they're supposed to have a tread design that has enough road contact and enough pitch that it cuts down on road noise and has good on-road handling. They also carry a mileage warranty. That is not something that you can say with a mud tire. Now, last night, it was about 10 o'clock, and like a normal college kid, I was sitting and watching Netflix, and I saw that it was snowing outside. And sure enough, it was snowing about 3 times the rate that it is right now. And it was all, the roads were probably 1 or 2 inches on the roads, and this was my chance to test out the new tires. And in as short of terms as I can put it, they did awesome. I've had General Grabbers, Michelin LTXs, Terra Grapplers, I've had Toyo Open Country MTs, I've had Aturo Trailblade MTs, and now I have these RTs. These are the best tire in the snow I have ever had, hands down. I was trying to get it to spin yesterday, drifting around in a parking lot, and it would start to spin and it would hook. And it was everything I could do just to get it to try to drift around last night in about 2 inches of snow. And that's never happened before. This truck typically slides in two-wheel drive if you really get on it and yank it through a turn. But these tires weren't having it. The traction in the snow yesterday was awesome. I drove it around for probably 1.5 hours, maybe 2 hours, because I was completely blown away at the performance. I was trying to find the biggest hills that I could go up. I was coming down the hills, and the tires were awesome. I mean, I wasn't sliding, spinning. I put it in two-wheel drive just to see, and usually if it's steep enough, if I'm in two-wheel drive, it'll go, but I'll spin, and I mean, it was barely spinning. Once the locker locked, I was on. I probably could have went almost everywhere I went last night in two-wheel drive if I really needed to. But these tires did awesome. Now, I'm going to bring you in a little bit closer here so you guys can see the tread design here on these RTs. Now, as you can see here, the tread design on the RT is a lot different than your normal mud terrain or all-terrain tire. It has, if you look at these lugs, they are really the same size as they would be on a mud terrain tire, but the channels, see, where they're individual lugs on a mud tire, they're pretty much all connected here on the RT. Now, I think the reason for that is to keep cut down on that road noise. The spacing between the lugs is not as big, which really helps the road. There's a lot more surface contact with both the road and the ground. And you can see here where the snow gets down in the channels and it is supposed to expel it here out through the sides. And I think that is another reason. All those things combined helps in the snow. And mainly it has to do with the amount of contact that the tire itself has with the asphalt, grass, dirt, whatever you're going to be driving on. Another common misconception that people have is they see these trucks rolling around with big old tires, you know, these 33 1250s. Well, it must be awesome in the snow. Well, they do fine in the snow, but believe it or not, a stock tire size does better in the snow than big, wide tires. And the reason for that is they tend to get the floating effect. They're not cutting down into the snow. They're riding on top of the snow. And that's another reason why on the mud tires, they really do not do good in just regular snow where it's, you know, 6 inches or less, because they really can't get down and grab the asphalt. There's not enough surface contact to really be effective like an all-terrain or just a regular all-season tire does. That would really be your best bet on a pickup truck if you really had to go out in the snow. But, you know, just because it's a big tire, that really doesn't mean that it's any better in the snow. Sometimes it's worse, in fact. And my mud tires prove that the bigger tire and the mud tires really don't do that great in little amounts of snow. So if you're interested in buying an RT tire, whether it be the Nitto Ridge Scrapper or the Toyo Open Country RT, I think it is a good buy. If you were somebody that is doing a whole lot of over the road, possibly is in an area where there's snow, do a little bit of off-road driving, and you need something that's not very loud and carries a mileage warranty, I think this tire would be awesome for you. There's going to be a video coming out soon, and it's going to be a full review of these tires once I put enough miles on them to really know what they do. I was lucky. I just put them on this weekend, and we got snow. I've been in rain, dry conditions, down the interstate, and in the snow. So I've gotten to do everything with these tires so far. The only thing left to do is to take them off-road, you know, down some up in the mountains or whatever. That's the last thing I haven't done. So we will get there and do that with these tires. And once I've done that, I will do the full review on these tires. But I like doing these snow videos. The last one did pretty good. You guys enjoyed that. Unfortunately, I can't drift around like you saw at the beginning of the video with these tires in my yard. It'll tear the yard apart. And there's nothing left on the roads for me to skid around with. We might get lucky and it might snow some more this weekend and I may be able to skid around in these tires. I'll throw that bit clip into the next video if I'm able to do that. But definitely follow me there on Instagram. You'll definitely get to see that first. Stay tuned, like, comment, and subscribe if you've got comments, or maybe you have an experience that you'd like to share with your mud tire, RT tire, all-terrain tire in the snow. Let me know that down in the description below. I mean, down in the comments section below. All the information on the truck is down in the description below as well. Stay tuned. Lots of cool stuff coming for this truck. And maybe, just maybe, we'll talk about getting another truck here on the channel. Not getting rid of this one, but kind of got some ideas coming up for you guys. So thanks again for watching. As always, take care. Have a great day.